we're very happy to share that we now bring you a session on port automation and digitization. India is committed to port development and port-led development. And we now bring you address by distinguished keynote speaker. Please welcome Shri Sanjay Bhatia, Up Lokayukt, Maharashtra State, former chairman, Mumbai Port Trust, and former chairman, Indian Ports Association. Sanjay ji, thank you very much for joining us in the global conference and a very warm welcome.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Just to add to your introduction, sir, Sanjay ji has served as a distinguished IAS officer for nearly 35 years. He belongs to the Maharashtra Cadre 1985 batch. He has held various levels of positions, having held positions of Chief Secretary in the State Government of Maharashtra and Secretary to the Government of India. He's a mechanical engineer, has done his MBA from Southern Cross, Australia. And we're extremely happy that Honorable Up Lokayukt Maharashtra State, Sanjay Bhatia ji, is with us for the keynote address. Sanjay ji, all yours. Thank you.
Thank you. I am actually very happy to see all this. There were some technical glitches in the beginning, but looks fantastic. TRGCC 2020. If you remember, a few years back in Mumbai, we had a Maritime India Summit. Now, in November, India is planning a Maritime India Summit virtually, the way you are doing it here.
Okay.
So it's good. This is my first experience with a virtual summit. So, and it will be on the same lines, an international Maritime India Summit, where some countries will be partner, and then, but everything virtual, like you guys are doing. So my congratulations for holding this sort of a virtual conference. Now regarding today's subject, automation. So I'll just, because the audience here is, I think, quite have a lot of information per se. So I'll just tell them what is probably not known. You know, this COVID period, this last 6 months, the shipping ministry has not only utilized it for running the ports and running various hospitals, but also utilized it for talking to various stakeholders and preparing a vision 2030. So I think there were about 250 meetings which took place. There are about 14 subjects which were identified, and that vision is now ready and is going to be presented to the Prime Minister in the next few days. So one of the subjects in that vision, and probably the most important subject in that, is ease of business and automation, what our country is going to do in the next 10 years. I was chairing that session when I was in the Mumbai port and in IPA. You know, when we were preparing the vision for 10 years in IT, we realized that we cannot prepare for 10 years. So we shortened it to 5 years. All the rest of the vision in the next 12, 13 topics is for 10 years. But for the information technology, IT, automation, we said 5 years, I can't even predict what is going to happen after 5 years. So therefore, we went in like this. Now the major part of that, the first major part of that vision, which is going to be completed in the next 2 years, is National Logistics Portal Marine. Now, what is this NLP? NLP is every marine activity will be on a PCS system, port community system. So anything which an importer or an exporter is doing, it will be digitized, it will be electronic, and vis-a-vis customs, vis-a-vis ports, vis-a-vis anyone which that importer and exporter is dealing with will be part of that NLP. it's quite a difficult task, and you would ask that how can it be done in 2 years. You know the method which we have adopted there. The method being used is that the original PCS, Port Community System Plus, which had been created for the major ports, is now getting upgraded for this marine thing. Vis-a-vis all other bodies, let's say shipping, customs, it's all an API integration through latching. So if anyone has developed a good system, a software system, and it is already running, or there is a startup which is coming, they can always latch on to this so that everyone can use this system. Every importer, exporter, all constituents can use this system for doing everything. So that is an NLP. And even when I was leaving, I think the tenders had been invited for NLP. And today, before I came here, I thought I must check up what is happening on that. The pre-bid meeting has taken place and there were 120 participants in the pre-bid meeting. So hopefully we will get a good bidder, and this NLP will be a great success in the next 1.5 years. My target was 1 year, but I think they have expanded it even further. So they have said 2022. So this is the first part, NLP. Second, which the major ports are doing, even if you do a port community system, with all the stakeholders, you're connected. But in the port, are we completely digitized? That is the second part of this. So we are going in for an ERP system in all the major ports. And finally, the minor ports will also join together in that. That project had been started a year back, and it is expected that this ERP system will reduce about 1800 processes in the ports, reduce from 1800 to 200, and standardize everything so that we have all the major ports have common processes so that they can be easily computerized. Now the expectation is that by next March, 2021 March, this system will also be ready. So all ports will be completely paperless inside also, not only outside. Through the NLP, you are doing it outside with every stakeholder, and through the ERP, you are doing everything inside also. So my expectation is by the end of 2021, you will probably have NLP and ERP both in place, and everything is paperless. Every payment is e-payment. Many of the processes, because they have been reduced, so maybe some agents will not be required anymore once this NLP comes. So this is NLP and ERP. Third thing which is being done is that the shipping ministry has identified in this stakeholders meeting about 50 plus digital initiatives, and those are for automation, for sensors, for crane, for quays, cranes. So 50 plus such initiatives have been identified for this purpose, which will be the third part of this vision. And that is expected to be completed in the next 1.5 year. Another thing which is being happening, and that is for shipping. For shipping, what is planned is that ship registration will be completely electronic. DG Shipping is going in for that. And this is expected to happen within a year. So these are the four major, and all these have number of subparts. Like under every initiative, there are about 25 things to be done, 25 to 30 things to be done. You're all aware that already through the initiatives which were taken by India in the ease of doing business vis-a-vis international trading, the rank which we had, we were 146th in 2018. It has already come down to 68. But with these new initiatives, it is expected that we should be in the top 30. Now that NLP which I mentioned is not only going to be India bound, The next step in NLP is that you also connect with other countries through this. Already there is a discussion going on with the Middle East countries and some associations in the Europe and USA to tie up and join with this NLP and PCS. So I'm sure it will be a grand success, and I wish the best to this panel discussion. I thought this is the latest thing, so I will just mention that. And please continue with the panel discussion. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Sri Sanjay Bhatiaji, for those enriching words. And like you shared, the maritime vision, the new digital initiatives that India is committed to, we're very sure that India will leverage technology to ensure benefit for the commodities market and trade per se. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us in this global conference.